Hello everyone. In this lecture, I am going to explain you knowledge representation and reasoning, which is the topic from artificial intelligence. So what is artificial intelligence or knowledge representation? Now you can see here in the picture that is a computer and this is a robot. So this computer or this machine is an empty box. Now we want to make it intelligent. So what is artificial intelligence? In artificial intelligence, we have to make machine intelligent so that it can work like human. So what is artificial intelligence? In this, we have to make machine intelligent so that it can work like human. So how to make it? To make machine intelligent, we have to give knowledge to the machine or computer. So what we have to do, we have to give knowledge to the machine or computer. Now why humans are intelligent? You can see here Einstein. Einstein was very, very intelligent. So why humans are intelligent? Because they have knowledge, information and data with them gathered throughout their experience. So what is intelligence? Ability to use gathered knowledge is intelligence. Ability to use the gathered knowledge is intelligence. Now, see this example. This is a diagram. Imagine this is you. Okay, there is a dig. So, what knowledge says? Knowledge gathered by you throughout your experience says that if you jump, it will hurt very badly. Why you know this? Because you have experiences, you have data, and you have information with you, which says that if you jump from this, it will hurt. And hence, what decision you will take? You will take a decision of not jumping from this point. So, you are intelligent. Why are you intelligent? Because you have knowledge, you have an ability to process the gathered information, and you have an ability to take decision. Since you are able to have all these things, it is said that you are intelligent. So what is reasoning? Reasoning is processing of knowledge for taking decision. Now let's take another example. Now, in the same example, in place of you, if we replace you by machine, now machine do not have any knowledge, any intelligence, any reasoning ability. So what it will do, it doesn't know that if it jumps, it will hurt. And what decision machine may take? Machine will take a decision of jumping. Now, what is artificial intelligence? Now, who is she? This is Sophia. All of you know this is a machine. Now, to make this machine intelligent, what we have to do? We have to do knowledge representation and reasoning. What is the meaning of knowledge representation and reasoning? Meaning is we have to induce knowledge, intelligence and reasoning into this machine. That means we have to induce, we have to enter information, knowledge and data into this machine so that it can work like human, it can think like human and it can make decisions like human. So what we have to do? We have to induce right knowledge in the machine so that it can process that knowledge and it takes right decisions. So I'm insisting here, right knowledge. Right knowledge is very, very important. If we give wrong knowledge to the machine, it will take wrong decision. In the language of computer, you know that if we write a program, right program, then we will get right output. That means if you write a correct program for calculation of area of circle, then only you will get the right calculation of area of circle, otherwise not. So what is the summary of what we learn till now? There are three factors which are put into the machine which makes it valuable. That is knowledge, The information related to the environment is stored in the machine. Reasoning. Reasoning is ability to process the information. And what is intelligence? Intelligence is ability to make decisions on the basis of stored information. Now, knowledge representation given to the machine should be correct. I already told you that if we give right information to the machine, then only it will give us right output. Now, let's take example. It is raining outside. This is correct statement. So, it is correct. Outside is raining. This is incorrect statement. Is it raining outside? It is raining outside. This is not a question. This is a statement. It is raining outside. But I put here question mark. So this is a correct statement. And it is raining outside. This is not a question. But still I put here question mark. This is incorrect statement. So in these statements, we made syntax errors, and in these statements we made grammatical errors. So we are not supposed to give such information to the machine. We should give only correct information. Correct means right information, like this. This is your right information. This is your right information. So if knowledge representation is correct, machine's understanding will be correct. If knowledge representation is wrong, machine will behave wrong. Okay. Now there are different techniques of knowledge representation. Different techniques of knowledge representation means different techniques of entering the data, information and knowledge in the machine. So which are four techniques? One is this logical representation, then semantic representation, then rules and frames. Let's learn one by one. So what is logical representation? Logical representation is the language with some concrete rules and has no ambiguity in representation. So this is very, very important. There should not be any ambiguity in representation. See, if there is some ambiguity in representation in the statements, we human have an ability to interpret the statement, but machine will not have this ability and hence may interpret it wrongly and will give wrong results. Logical representation means drawing a conclusion based on various conditions. Now, logical representation. Let me change the color of the pen. Now, logical representation. There are two types of logical representation, that is propositional logic and predicate logic. What is propositional logic? In this logic, it is in the form of true and false statement. And predicate logic, it is in the form of quantity. It is quantitative. It is in the form of mathematical equations. Now let's take an example of propositional logic. So these are declarative statements. Let's see these statements. It is raining, so raining. It is sunny, so sunny. So these are declarative statements, which is example of propositional logic. And let's see the example of predictive logic. These are quantitative statements. You can see a statement X is greater than Y is represented in predicate logic as greater into bracket x comma y. So this is how in predicate logic you have to enter information in this form, and in propositional logic we have to enter information in the form of statements. Next is semantic network. Semantic network is another technique by which we have to enter information in the machine. So what is meaning of semantic? Semantic meaning is meaning only. What is network? Network's meaning is graph. So what is semantic network? Semantic network means meaningful graph. Okay. So knowledge in semantic networks, knowledge is stored in the system in the form of graph. The example of semantic network is Google Graph. Now we'll study one example. Now, let's consider this example. Consider the given knowledge stored in the machine. What knowledge is stored? Ram has cycle. Ram is a boy. Cycle has a bell. Ram is 12 years old. Cycle has two pedals. Now, how to represent this example by semantic network? Like this. You can see. So, Ram is a boy. Ram is 12 years old. Ram has cycle. Cycle has bell. And cycle has two pedals. So, this is example of semantic network. So, in this technique, information is represented in the form of graphs. So, in these nodes, this is node, this is node. So, these nodes of graph represents object. And these arrows, you can see, this is arrows. These arrows represent relationship between this object and this object. This object and this object. So, such technique shows the connectivity of one object with the another object. Now, rules. Rules is the next type of knowledge representation. This is the another technique of entering information in the machine. So, what rule says? It is the knowledge in the form of if and then statements. See, very, very important. What is rules? Rules is in the form of if and then statement. Let's see example. If this condition is true, then do this, like this. If temperature is below 10 degree, then weather is cold. Very simple. You know that we give such kind of statements to the computer while writing computer program. And these type of statements are known as rules, a technique by which we can enter information in the machine so that it can take decisions based on these statements. Next type of knowledge representation is frame. What is knowledge representation? Don't forget, it is the way by which we enter information in the machine. So, next type is frame. It is a record-like structure which consists of collection of attributes and its value to describe an entity in the world. So, let's take an example of frame. Through frame, how to do the knowledge representation? Let's take an example of frame for a book. So, how to represent this? It is represented in the form of table. You can see this is slots and these are filters. So, title, artificial intelligence, author, Peter, year of publishing, edition, page, etc. So, in this, knowledge is represented in the form of tables, or it is in the form of collection of attributes. Now, another example. Let's suppose we are taking an entity Peter. Peter is an engineer as a profession and his age is 25. He lives in city London and in the country England. So, how to represent it? You can represent it like this. So, these are the slots and these are filters. So, this is how you can represent the knowledge by using technique frames. So, I hope you understood this video and enjoyed it. Thank you.